تعالى ان الله سبحانه وتعالى talked about this in the Quran. Like, can somebody say, well, the المشركون they said سيقول الذين اشركوا لو شاء الله ما اشركنا نحن ولا اباؤنا ولا كذا في اكثر من آية more than آية ولا حرمنا من دونه من if Allah wills that those who disbelieve or those who took rivals with Allah سبحانه وتعالى the polytheists they said if Allah will or had Allah will we would have never taken anybody with him as God like it's because of him not because of us he willed it and so it happened and they said قالوا لو شاء الرحمن ما عبدناه they said if الرحمن the compassionate will we wouldn't have worshipped those idols so that's always there trying to use this tactic against Allah but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like the Quran usually اسلوب القرآن is so simple and so easy what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قل هل عندكم من علم فتخرجوه لنا say to them tell them do you have knowledge of that do you really know that Allah willed that you should worship these do you have knowledge of that so you can show us this knowledge انت تتبعون الا الظن you just follow a ظن assumption you assume something in your mind and you go by it theory like Darwin there's nothing wrong with Darwin as a theory but actually it's against our faith as far as the part of the beginning of the creation how did creation come to existence not about adaptation and the peak of birds and all of that so theory one becomes always should remain as doubt but it should never be used as basis or ground that should be only the facts should be there So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replied to them, وَقَالُوا لَوْ شَاءَ الرَّحْمَنُ مَا عَبَدْنَاهُمْ Very simply, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا لَهُمْ بِذَلِكَ مِنْ عِلْمٍ They have no knowledge about that. They said in Surah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as he said in Surah Al-A'raf, وَإِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً قَالُوا وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهَا آبَاءَنَا وَاللَّهُ أَمَرَنَا بِهَا Whenever they do something wrong, not only as faith, فاحشة, they do bad, they do indecency. Whatever they do, they said, this is how we found our parents. وَاللَّهُ أَمَرَنَا بِهَا Meaning the qadr of Allah. And that's what Allah commanded to be. This is how it is. If Allah willed otherwise, it would have been. قُلْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَأْمُرُ بِالْفَحْشَاءِ Say, Allah does not order or command fahsha. No, Allah clearly orders goodness and to worship Him alone and to do this and that. You cannot say that Allah willed otherwise because you don't know what did Allah will. You should stop there. You don't know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala willed for you, and that should be يعني the end of it. The other issue, the second issue is وصف الله سبحانه وتعالى بالمكر. We read in the Quran many ayat وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ They make a plan and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes a plan. Makr in Arabic is usually carries what? A negative meaning. It refers to plotting like the criminals or the Some people are setting a secret plan to get somebody in trouble. That's how it is for Arab people, right? Makr. In reality, makr, or in linguistically, المكر في الأصل التدبير الخفي المفضي بالمنكور به إلى ما لا يحتسب is to do something, some secret plan that would lead the person that you are planning this against him to do something or to cause him or to cause something to happen to him that you wouldn't expect. So to plan something secretly to lead to certain consequences without that person knowing that. But in reality, not talking about Allah now, we could have some kind of al-makr al-hasan. Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا يَحِبُّ الْمَكْرُ السَّيِّئُ The bad plotting, the bad planning is only going to come to those, the authors of it, or those who did it. It's going to come back to them. But there is makr jayyid. So if, for example, assuming that police forces and law enforcement and people who are They, to deal with the criminals, they have to have some makr, right? They have to spy, they have to do certain things dealing with the criminals to get them, not with the innocent people. We have to draw the line here. With criminals, they might do certain things to traps, if you like, to get them. That's makr. But can you say this is bad? No, this is not bad. They're trying to get the bad people, so they have to use the same strategy. And you can, some of the makr even, you may call it makr. You're trying to even lie, to get two people who are in trouble with each other to make peace between them. And in Islam, even if you lie in discourse or making peace between them, reconciliation between them, it's not lying, it's actually something good. So this is kind of makr, trying to for goodness to get two people together, and we all know that. So المكر السيء, when Allah said, described himself on المكر, he said ويمكرون ويمكر الله. They are planning and Allah is planning. They are plotting and Allah is planning, or plotting as well, not in the negative sense. They are planning or plotting to do what? Talking about the people of Mecca. وَإِذْ يَمْكُرُوا بِكَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِيُثْبِتُوكَ أَوْ يَقْتُلُوكَ أَوْ يُخْرِجُوكَ. They convened together and they were planning to put you in prison, to kick you out of Mecca, to kill you. They had some plans secretly, and they, in the morning, they finalized their plotting or planning that. Elect somebody from each qabila, from each tribe. They go to the house of Muhammad, they kill Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and they kill him like one person, and nobody can do anything. That's planning, that's plotting, right? Trying to do something secretly that the person would not expect. But Allah too, yamkur, Allah is having a secret plan. You don't know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is planning for you. You might think that this power of yours right now, being young, being wealthy, being whatever, is going to continue forever. You don't know, maybe 1 month from now, it's going to end. And the reason you are taking all of that strength or position, whatever position you are taking is there, you don't know that 1 month from now it's going to be gone. So that's makr from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you do not know. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing that, He's doing that as a punishment for them. He is first dealing with them, يُعَاقِبُهُمْ بِجِنْسِ مَا يعني تعاملهم معه. He is dealing with them in the same way. And if we understand this point, we understand so many ayat. Like يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ إِنَّ مَلَقِينَ يُخَادِعُونَ اللَّهَ وَهُوَ خَادِعُونَ. They deceive Allah, but actually Allah is deceiving them. Deceiving, it has a negative sense. But because they do that secretly, thinking that they are deceiving Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also planning something secretly for them. And مُشَابَهَةً نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنَسِيَهُمْ. They forget Allah, and Allah forgot them. Does Allah forget? No, He doesn't forget. But they behave as if there is no Allah. They just forget about Him. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, day of judgment, He will behave as if those people are not there, as if He forgot them. لكن المكر في حق الله تبارك وتعالى عدل. When they do this plotting, for example, to kill the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to do this and that, is that right? Did he do anything for you? This is transgression. إنه لا يأمر القوم الخاسرون. This is transgression. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala plotted against them, that all of that is going to go. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to be saved. And he's going to go, and a few years from now, he's going to be stronger, come back to you. And that's going to be the end for the arrogance of Meccan people. That's the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the secret plan that nobody knew about it. But why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove them after being the stronger Quraysh and so on? He removed them because they started transgressing. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed them عُقُوبَةً لَهُمْ. So this is the makr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He is implementing His justice, His adl, His justice against the people, using the same tool that the people use. They deceive Him, they do something secretly, so He replied or He give them the same way. Believers should always not feel 100% secure, not because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but because of they don't know. We have sins. We do. Every single person of us, we might have sins. A believer will always do good and count on two things. He fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he counts at the same level. He counts on the maghfirah and rahmah and mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not feeling 100% secure until he is completely in Jannah, in there. And the opposite. Wal'asi, the disbelievers or the disobedient people, they make the asiyan and they feel secure. They go against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completely and they feel secure. Like, and we see that in our life many times. Al-mujtahid da'iman, the person who is, you know, he's going to hurt himself, something is going to happen. So we see that al-mujtahid, يعني في الدراسة وكذا, somebody is doing good, studying all year. You study and you did everything. And tomorrow is the test. What do you think? Versus somebody who doesn't really care. He did not turn any homework or did pay. He did not study. And tomorrow is the test. What? So what do you think that the case of the two people? Somebody, you did good. He read the, you know, he studied. He did everything, yet he is worried. I'm not going to sleep tonight. Let me just read it one more time. Let me get that, right? This is a mujtahid, the good person. He always cares. When is going to be the minute that he will, you know, feel good? Even after the test and he did good. He is still worried about the result. Until the result comes, he is happy now. The other person, you know, he doesn't really care. That is exactly the case of a believer who does good. وَالَّذِينَ يَبْتُونَ مَا آتَ وَقُلُوبُهُ مَجْلَةً. They do good things, but their heart is, they have fear. Is it accepted or not? أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَجْعُونَ. Sayyidah Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, is that ayah about the people who do bad, but they still, because of some faith in there, they feel bad that they did bad? He said, no, this is about the people who do good, but they still, Ya Rabbi, we give sadaqah. Is it going to be accepted or not? So قلوبهم مجل أنهم إلى ربهم رجعون. Because of that, Allah gives them ultimate security in Jannah. Because they live in some kind of being worried, Allah gives them security. أولئك لهم الأمن وهم مهتدون. But the other people, they felt completely secure in here, even though they didn't do anything to benefit them in there, then they lose security. قولوا قولي هذا وصلى الله عليه وسلم.